There was a woman born from a lotus. Her heart was golden, deep as the ocean.
What's up, guys? Okay, so we're going to be doing another video today. I'm going to be doing an Ulta haul. I bought a couple things just to like kind of try new products, and I just love Ulta because they have travel size products, and I love travel size products because like I just think it's really cool to be able to try a product first before you spend so much on the full size and never use it or not like it or be the wrong color or whatever the case may be. So the first thing that I want to talk about, of course, because it's going to be the first step to your makeup, is going to be a setting mist collection. But I got this kit. Everybody knows, you know, what this brand is, I feel like, at this point. But yeah, it just comes with all of the scents. So it's like a mist. You always want to prime your face, tone your face. It helps, you know, just keep everything fresh and dewy. You can set your makeup with these, but I'm gonna use it as like a pre-skin prep. So there is all the different, you know, very refreshing, smells really good. I love toners, and I just love having that refreshing mist to be able to use out on a daily. So I've actually never used this before, but I know it's really popular and everyone talks about it and uses it pretty much. I just never really got it, but I'm glad I got it, and I know I'll love it. They all smell amazing. So I went ahead and did my brows and concealed my face, you know, correcting them spots. So the next thing that I got from Ulta that I was really excited to get was this banana powder from Revolution. And it is, it was a really good price. It was not expensive at all, but I've seen a couple people use it, and I really just, the setting powder I use, I feel like it's not orange enough. You know, like it was just too pale, too powdery, if you will. So I'm trying to figure out how to get this lid off. Okay, so I guess I'm gonna just pour it in the lid because this is very small dispenser, and I just like to take this powder and pat it all over my face. So I like to use like a concealer that's like kind of orange undertone to correct my blemishes, and then put in the powder over it to set the concealer. And then I like to go back over it with my foundation. So that's just what I'm going to do right now, really quickly. Compared to my other powders, it's not like, the consistency of the powder is not so grainy. So I like it. It goes on really smooth, and I feel like, you know, like when I blend it in, it blends well. It doesn't look like as pale. It looks really good mixed with my skin tone. So, or mixed with this concealer, so. I like it. So the next thing I bought from Ulta that I've been wanting to try is this Wet n Wild contour stick, and it is in, what is this shade, it is shade 8048 Oaks on You, looks like on my skin. A quick swipe. So that's obviously not a contour shade for me. Online it looked kind of darker, maybe not, but I do like the consistency of it, and it looks like very like a pretty thick product. It's not like super watery, or doesn't feel bad, doesn't look ashy, it feels good. So I like it, I just think it's not quite for me. So for foundation, I'm just gonna be using Fit Me in the color 330 Toffee. I like to use like a kind of orange-based concealer and then use like a more yellow undertoned foundation to balance it out, because I have a really weird skin tone and it just looks weird if I use a foundation that has like a more orange undertone. So whenever I blend this together, it looks really good. Like, it matches really well with me. Something like this, something a little more diverse, is this e.l.f. cream contour palette. I usually use powder contour, but I've been wanting to try cream contour, and this one was very inexpensive. I have pretty much a flawless base. I'm gonna go ahead and try this contour, this cream contour. I'm just gonna probably use this shade and see how it looks on me. Okay, I don't think I'm mad at it. I don't know, let's just keep working it in and see. This is a good formula. I really like the consistency. I like how it blends. And I like the shade of it. I'm not mad at it. I'm probably gonna go in with powder still. But I do really like the product. And I like the variety. I'm sorry. I like the variety of the shades So the next thing I bought from Ulta is this hydrating camo conceal from e.l.f. Now I do already use this and I love it, and I already used it for the base of my face to conceal my blemishes. But I'm not gonna actually use this today because I want to try this concealer that came in my Ipsy. So it's really small, but it's it says bye bye under eye. It's a waterproof full coverage concealer, and I really want to try it. It's really small, it's just a tester, so I'm just gonna try that. But yeah, this did come with my Ulta haul, and I do recommend you buy it. I've already used it before, so I'm not really gonna use it today because I do want to try all new products. So yeah, so I'm just going to take this on my hand, and it's very thick already, you can tell, very thick. I love the shade of it. I feel like it's perfect, like the perfect shade, and it's not gonna be too bright. I feel like a lot of the time the concealers I use are too bright for me, and I've just been trying to find the different different color ranges. But I'm just gonna apply that to the areas. Very thick, very thick, very, love the moisturizing, very like, wow. And I love this brush, by the way. I got this brush in my Ipsy as well. This brush is a concealer brush and is so amazing. It is so amazing. Like, so soft, so perfect for blending. I really love this concealer. It is very thick. I love the shade. It's like so perfect. I feel like it's gonna fit really well with my skin tone. Cause I always feel like I would use a concealer that was too bright, not orange enough, or too orange. And this is like the perfect balance. Look how beautiful that is, like, yeah. Love it, love it, love it, love it. Now, the one thing I will say, I just love so much about the Real Techniques brushes. They're so dense. Like, these brushes are so dense and they blend so well, like so soft, so effortlessly. Love them. Look at that. Yes, this is a really nice concealer. I'm definitely going to look into getting a full size of this. So this is after, applying the same powder, the Revolution Banana Powder. And I really like it. I feel like on camera it looks kind of brighter than it is in the natural light, but that might just be because I forgot to turn on my ring light and I already started recording and I don't want my lighting to be so different. So natural light it is. It's cool. How did I forget to turn on my ring light? I don't know, guys. Don't know. But I'm gonna go back in and contour a little more since I just talked. So I went ahead and turned my ring light on just because it wasn't doing it no justice, y'all. Like, when I turn the light on, you can tell. Let's just get into this base. Like, you can tell so much better. And yeah, so we just gonna continue like this. Okay. Anyways, next step. Okay, y'all. So this next thing, I didn't even order this. I didn't even know that what this was. But Ulta did this thing where you spend a certain amount and they gave you like a free, a big gift bag. And it came with like so much stuff, some full size, some samples, some really cool stuff. And I actually forgot. Came with a couple other things that are just like, you know, just like things I didn't order, just a couple sample things. But this is basically it's a tinted peach pink balm. That's what it says, Dr. Paw Paw. So what it basically is like a blush and like a lip tint. And it's cruelty free, fragrance free, and vegan. Love it. So we're gonna go ahead and try it. I never thought to try a liquid blush. Would this be called a liquid blush, or would this be considered like a cream blush? I don't know. I don't know how to describe this consistency, but it's like that. So I think I'm going to just put it on my finger and use my brush to apply it instead of putting it all the way. Can't see it very well. I like my blush to be really pink. teeth to be really pink, so. But I do like that it's cream. Kind of goes with the theme I'm trying to go for. So you can't really see it, but it is a very light tint. I could see if you were wearing like no makeup or like fair skin. You can tell the difference though. This has blush, this side doesn't. Okay, y'all, I take that back. I went in and I applied like another layer. And I'm not gonna hold you. I really do like this because it gives a really nice natural finish. It's not too bright. It blends very well. It's really just kind of like a moisturizing glowy tint. I like it. I'm here for it. Okay, so now I decided to contour my nose with the lighter shade and see if I like that, you know. And I think it looks really good, the lighter shade and this one. So when I mix them, I feel like it gives me a really good contour. And it's like so, I just love the cream. I love the cream look instead of the powder. I haven't even, okay. So the next thing that I got, which was free also, was this travel size Maybelline mascara. And very familiar with Maybelline mascara, would recommend. I mean, it's mascara. Love this wand. I'm just gonna put a little bit underneath for the sake of the video. Something I love the most, which is the Morphe continuous setting mist. I had this before as a gift and I love it. I love how it's a setting mist, so it's not like really harsh and it's continuously just spraying. They were actually sold out of the full size, otherwise I would have bought the full size. But the travel size, it's sufficient. It's still a really good size, so I'm not mad at it. And I'm also not mad at it because I got another Morphe setting mist, the Madison Bear Morphe setting mist. Y'all, I seen this on someone else's page. I don't remember who's, someone else's makeup page. And I just seen the bottle and I was like, that is so beautiful. That's a setting mist, like, woo. It said 8 to 10 inches. I don't know if that was 8 to 10 inches, but it smells amazing. It smells so good. And I just feel like, wow. It just smells really good. It looks good too. It looks good too. Let it dry for a little bit, see how it sets, but definitely a very glowy setting mist. Okay, so the next thing I got was this lip kit from Kat Von D, I believe that's the name of the brand. It is like a mini kit, so these are small, but it came with 4 different colors, and I want to say this was like $10, I don't know. But I was not mad at it because look at how beautiful. Look at how beautiful these are. They're so beautiful. I don't know, should I do some swatches of them? But these, so beautiful. So these are the swatches. And they're very vibrant, very creamy, very moisturizing. And they're so pretty. I feel like they're good colors to go on darker skin, or not, you know, brown skin. So I like them. But I think I'm gonna wear this one. and put on some lip liner and be back. I lined my lips with this red NYX pencil and we're gonna use this shade and see how it mixes. I feel like it'll be pretty. So thick. Overall, very good quality lipstick. It's not cracking my lips. It's not really dry. It's very moisturizing, very thick. You see, I did like one swipe. I really like that mix with that color, I'm not gonna lie to you. But I am gonna line it in brown and be back. After I lined it in brown a little bit, that's so pretty. Like, the texture of this lip gloss is really good. It's really soft. We'll see how the longevity is. So as far as makeup goes, that's pretty much all the products I bought that were makeup products from Ulta. I am trying to slowly but surely upgrade my kit and learn about different products and, you know, brands and things like that. So slowly but surely, but I really like everything that I purchased. This is a full face using pretty much everything that I bought today, except for the foundation. And I love it much. But the next thing I bought is some brushes. I bought some brushes from Real Techniques. And I love the Real Techniques brushes because they're so dense. These are eye brushes. So I got a double sided brush. It comes with a spoolie on the end. It's the reflection for me. And then this brush is perfect for, you know, creases and everything. I just love the density, the texture, the brush, the bristles. They're so easy to clean. I love that they're metal. So these brushes are number one. Eventually I will invest and have probably all Real Techniques. So I did already have on lashes and I'm not gonna do my eyes today. Just gonna keep it simple. But they did give me some lashes. I don't really wear Ardell lashes, especially not ones this small. But like I said, they came with it. And these could go on, they say they're water activating. So like you just dip them in water, I guess. Personally, I probably wouldn't rely on that. But Ardell lashes are not horrible. They're cool. What is this? Skin Fortifying Daily Booster. Mineralizing water and hyaluronic acid. So this could be used as like a primer. It's just a trial size. It's very, very small. But it sounds interesting. It sounds very refreshing. It's very cute. So I should have probably used this. But it was so little, I didn't see it in the bottom of the box. So, next time. Next, they gave me this vanilla perfume. I don't like vanilla scent, but thank you, Ulta. And then I got this ultra hydrating scalp treatment. I am excited to try this, actually. I wanted to try it today, but I'm gonna wait because I'm gonna be dyeing my hair again probably soon. And I love doing treatments after I dye my hair, just to make sure that my curls stay hydrated and all that good stuff. Next thing I got was, for free, this hair mask. It's Cake Natural Looks Beauty, the Smooth Move. So I have curly hair, so I always love a mask. Like I say, I love any kind of treatments, anything to make these curls more curly, give me some more volume. I feel like it's essential to mask your hair, and I really didn't know that at first. So if you got curly hair, if you flat iron your hair a lot, after you flat iron your hair, do a hair mask. Or do a protective style, or braid your hair up, you know. Just make sure you're moisturizing your curls, girl. Moisturize them curls with some oil. And then they gave me a mineral bath salt. eucalyptus as well, an essential oil. So I just use this. Who doesn't love bath salt, relaxing baths, and scents? Kinda love them. But that is everything that I got from Ulta. So I did love doing this video. I was kinda hesitant because I was like, how am I going to be able to make a video talking and doing my makeup? But I did good. So if you liked it and want to do like a makeup get ready with me, or a chit chat get ready with me, I plan on doing things like that. I'll probably even do like maybe some try on hauls or lookbook hauls, or like I just love to make outfits and stuff like that. So but thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. Comment below what your favorite product was, or any questions that you have about the products, and I will follow up with you. I appreciate you tuning in, and hopefully I see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.